too.
What's up, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Hidden Gems in South Florida. If this is your first time tuning in, you don't want to miss my previous episode, in which I take you guys to Robert Is Here to explore the exotic fruits and vegetables, milkshakes, smoothies, desserts, and so much more. And just as a reminder, I'm taking the proper COVID-19 measures, as per the CDC guidelines, to ensure the safety of myself and of others. Now let's get started with this week's Hidden Gem in South Florida. This week's Hidden Gem takes us straight to Biscayne National Park, situated in Homestead, Florida, but within sight of downtown Miami and just minutes away from the Homestead Miami Speedway. I don't know, but I have to mention this. These past couple of weeks have been super stressful and has caused me to be super tired from all the work I have received through my job and from school. I don't know why people decide to take more than 4 classes a semester. And that was personally my biggest mistake. But if you're doing that, I salute you. And I know it's tough, but I don't know how you guys managed to do that. But all I know is I'm simply not doing that ever again. It's my biggest mistake and I regret it. However, something that I've always loved to do to take away from my stress and to feel relaxed is to go to different bodies of water like the beach, the pool, or something that's simply surrounded by water. And this is why I took you guys to Biscayne National Park. It has been able to take away my stress and has led me to be less tired. I don't know, something about the smell from the fresh water, the fresh wind, always causes me to be super relaxed. And this is why I wanted to show you all the things available at this national park. Biscayne National Park is open every day from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and have placed proper social distancing guidelines. I love how Biscayne has a subtropical climate that brings sunshine for over 300 days out of the year, but expect winters to be dry with less humidity. Additionally, the park has 4 different types of ecosystem that help protect more than 20 endangered or threatened species. These ecosystems include mangroves, bays, islands, and reefs. But it blows my mind to know the diversity of wildlife found within the park. You are bound to find more than 500 fishes alone, besides all the reptiles, amphibians, birds, and mammals. I can assure you that this park attracts South Florida residents and people from all around the world. They have opportunities for boating, fishing, snorkeling, paddleboarding, camping, hiking, cultural exploration, and so many more options to explore the northernmost part of the Florida Keys. But one of my best memories, or something that is always like deep in my mind, like, oh, I wish I can go back in time to do that, besides going to relieve stress or when I'm tired, have time for myself, was going every Easter Sunday at around 10 or 11 to Biscayne National Park. So after church, we would be like, hey, let's go to Biscayne National Park. Our friend was there, and they would just wait for my parents to come and cook. Yes, my parents are the best cooks. Sorry if I'm being biased, but they throw it down in the kitchen. Anyways, so when we got there, the music was playing. They had the grill going off. You can smell the chicken. And it was so packed. Like, there was no room for us to, like, move. But we made the most of it. It was actually pretty fun. We threw the eggs on the floor, got the candy. But one thing's for sure is we always, always picked up after ourselves. Like, we never left a paper or anything that could be harmful for the animals or the ecosystem surrounding it. But that was one thing we always made sure was, like, spot on, kept it clean. But my favorite memory of all was taking off my shirt, taking off my shorts, and just running to the water. The water was freezing cold, but I didn't know what I was thinking. Like, I just enjoyed the moment, like, laughter. I had friends there, family there, so what better way to spend a holiday than being with your loved ones? It was actually super fun. I wish I can go back. I probably won't take my shirt off or my shirts off now since I'm older, I'm more responsible now. Before, it was just like a thought of, hey, let's go, let's rush. But it's so fun to think of the many memories I made at that park alone, and more stuff that I wish I can, or hope that my children can experience as well. You are in need of a guide, not a worry. The Biscayne National Institute offers private and small experiences that help you gain a deeper connection with the park, the history, and the different habitats available. If you want more information, please feel free to visit this website, and you don't want to miss the different opportunities available to you. Overall, I rate this hidden gem in South Florida a 10 out of 10. You are able to forget about the city noises, everything going on with your life, to take in the freshness of the air, the waves clashing, and overall it's so calming. You forget about everything going on in your mind and you're just zoned out peacefully, knowing that there's nature around you. You can take in so many things, rethink about life, and it's something that I recommend you guys go. And if you ever have the time to visit, please let me know. Comment down below if you have or if you plan on visiting. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Hidden Gems in South Florida.